It happened. I don't believe it happened, but it happened. Michigan just won the national championship. It doesn't seem real, even though I was there on the sidelines watching it all unfold. We're going to get into it this episode of Locked On Wolverines.
You are Locked On Wolverines, your daily podcast on the Michigan Wolverines, part of the Locked On Podcast Network.
Happy Tuesday. We are back and doing it. Locked On Wolverines podcast, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, where it's your team every day. I'm your man on the ground, Isaiah Hole, publisher of Wolverines Wire. I am in my hotel room here in Houston to just get into it, right? Michigan beats Washington 34-13 to win the national championship, 15-0 for the first time in program history. It is, I really, truly cannot believe it. It's kind of bizarre in some ways because it kind of feels like it was the more emotional game was the Rose Bowl, because you had the Rose Bowl itself. You had Alabama, all of that drama. And it felt almost like the national championship was a formality. It was kind of in a way very similar. I don't know how you felt, but to me, it felt very similar to beating Ohio State in 2021 and then winning the Big Ten championship, right? It's getting to the Big Ten championship was the more exciting moment than actually winning the Big Ten, right? That's kind of how it felt. But it feels very surreal because we have spent so long, especially it's the 10th year of the college football playoff. It's been 25 years since the last national championship, but Michigan's never played in a championship game, right? They didn't play in any of the BCS versions. They didn't play in any of the college football playoff versions until now. So it would have been maybe different in some ways if it would have been like, okay, they beat TCU and then they lost to Georgia. And now, you know, we know what that feels like. We didn't know what this felt like to even play in this game, let alone to win it. So it is kind of just unbelievable. And it feels like destiny in so many ways. That's kind of been the whole thing here, right? Like, which team is actually more destined to win? Because Washington was also similarly counted out throughout constantly. And yet, Michigan was the one, right? I won't share their name because I don't know if they want me to or not, but a parent of a player told me after the game that this was there were two things that were brought up to this team before the game. The lesser of the two is that Michigan won the national championship 100 years ago to this day, 1923. So that is, and it was a shared championship, but it was a shared championship that they had, national championship rather, in 1923. But even more so, Michi died a year ago today, or a year ago the day of the thing. So that really had an emotional impact on them, and they really wanted to go out and win this for Michi, who did not unfortunately get a chance to see this. So they wanted to do it in his honor. And this is a team for all of the you know, as I screech cheating and all of that, you know, that everyone loves to throw out there. This is a team that maintains their innocence. Jim Harbaugh said as much today at the post-game press conference. I know a lot of people are going to disagree with this if you aren't a Michigan fan. This is a team that does things the right way. And you can throw out all your Connor Stallions, what have you, and say the whole team knew and blah, blah, blah. It's just the latter part is just not true, okay? So this is a team that does things the right way, and they really wanted to go out and earn this to vindicate themselves, as Jim Harbaugh said after the game. And I think to a lot of people in the media, now I don't know, I haven't been on Twitter yet at all throughout all of this. I've barely gotten any work done, really, just because it's just, you know, you have this whole long process after all of it to kind of just pull everything together, you know, go and talk to different players and stuff, and you know, whether there's the formal interviews or the on and off the record, all of that stuff. So I don't really know what everyone is saying, but I mean, this is the most monumental moment in Michigan football history. I'm not afraid to say that. Now, I do think that the Rose Bowl game was that until this one, right? Because now, and that was probably the harder battle, right? Because obviously they beat Alabama by 7 in overtime, but you had to get past the SEC, right? And you had to do so. It wasn't Nick Saban's best team, but you still had to get past them. Kind of similar as well to the idea of, like, I always bring this up on the show, and maybe it shows my age to the younger people, but the 2004 Pistons, right? Once they got past the Pacers, and even though everyone was calling it a coronation for the Lakers, I remember reading a literal article in the LA Times that was like, you know, you can go ahead and plan the parade and all that kind of stuff. To the Pistons fans, they knew once you get past the Pacers, you'll get past the Lakers. I kind of feel like that was kind of maybe how everyone was feeling about the national championship. But it is surreal. Like, I just walked into Media Hospitality and it's just packed with people. They had a suckling pig for some reason. And just looking up at ESPN, which I haven't seen a minute of right today. And you look up and you just see highlights of Michigan, national championship, Michigan. And just remembering how that first one went, 2014, when Ohio State under Urban Meyer wins it. In that year in particular, I remember my best friend calling me earlier that year after the Mark Helfrich Oregon press conference, the Jesus Girls and Marcus Mariota. And I remember my best friend calling me and saying, why can't we have that? Look at how much fun they're having. Because Michigan was enduring the tail end of Brady Hoke. It was the Shane Morris concussion, and everything was just going awry. They didn't make a bowl game. Brady Hoke is out. No one knows if Harbaugh is going to come yet. It just felt like the absolute pits, and then it's tail-ended by Ohio State, of all teams, winning the national championship. Absolutely bizarre world, right? And here you are 10 years later. Jim Harbaugh hired before that game. 10 years later, Jim Harbaugh makes good, wins that national championship that everyone hoped he could do. And it was absolutely surreal. There's some other notes that I have. I do want to go over some of the stats. There's some really enlightening stats in here. We're going to keep on delving in a little bit. I just not delayed my flight. I bought a new flight, so I'll be in Houston a whole another day and a half here, because the weather is really bad, and I want to be at this press conference tomorrow morning. So there is that. So we are going to get to all of this stuff. Really cool note that you're going to absolutely love to hear. I guarantee no one else is telling you about this. We're going to get to that in just a moment. But before we do, I know we come to sports to escape from the crazy realities of real life, but can we just talk for a minute about preparing for real life? According to the FDA, pharmacies are running out of antibiotics like amoxicillin right in the middle of the worst flu season in over a decade. That is scary stuff, right? So I can't imagine a more helpless feeling than if, you know, Sarah and the kids, if they got sick while a supply chain issue kept them from the life-saving medication that they needed. Thankfully, everyone's going to be all right because we went to Jace Medical. Jace Case is a pack of 5 different antibiotics that treat a long list of bacterial illnesses, including UTIs, respiratory infections, sinusitis, skin infections, amongst others. This stuff can happen to any of us. Visit JaceMedical.com and complete your physician encounter. It'll be reviewed by a board-certified physician, and your medications will be dispensed by a licensed pharmacy at a fraction of the regular cost. It's never been more important to be prepared than today. So go to jasemedical.com. Use the offer code LOCKEDON. Get $20 off of your order. That's jasemedical.com. Promo code LOCKEDON. All right, we are here in the hotel room, the ugliest set we have had here on this show in a very long time. But yeah, it's late. I didn't want to go out, even though the Media Hospitality is booming at the moment. It is jam-packed full of people I hadn't seen all week. I don't know where they were. But everyone is obviously here to be a part of the national championship. And it's just interesting, you're right, just seeing all of the people that you've seen on TV all of the time, just kind of in and around. But it is an absolute, this is going to be a day that Michigan fans remember forever. Yeah, you'll remember the Rose Bowl as well, but you'll certainly, even though maybe it wasn't quite the same level of exciting game, this one against Washington, it is a game that you will remember forever because it's no matter what rival fans want to say with all of their screeching and ridiculousness, you're going to look at this and you're going to say, well, Michigan won fair and square. And a lot of people will say, this is actually kind of the most legitimate national championship ever because they didn't, they didn't even have their sign stealer. Everyone else had their sign stealers, and Michigan didn't even have that. They had extra NCAA scrutiny all across the board and managed to win the championship against the most prolific SEC team and then against a brand new Big Ten team in Washington who had the top offense in the country that everyone was talking about. But what did I tell you on Monday earlier? I said, even though I had a much higher score and I actually had a smaller point margin because I had 45 to 26. So I had a 19 point. They won by 21. They didn't score quite as much. But at the same time, I told you this wasn't going to be about Michigan's defense against the Washington offense as much. And now it did end up being that, right? Michigan defense completely shut down Washington in kind of a similar way to how they shut down Ohio State just in 2021, just even worse. But it came down to the offense, right? The offense led the way against the Washington defense. Now, I was kind of surprised that it got stagnant. It seemed like it got predictable. Washington figured out how to stop the run suddenly. But when I say that, we go to the stats, right? It's kind of crazy what Michigan did. No other team in the national championship game under the college football playoff era has rushed for 303 yards. And it is insane when you think about it, because what was the big talking point in 2021 when Michigan beat Washington? It was that they ran for 300 yards, and they picked a heck of a time to run for that much for the first time this year, right? They didn't accumulate 300 yards rushing once this year, and they do it in the national championship game. JJ McCarthy, 10 for 18, not his best day, but I mean, it wasn't all him, right? He had a couple drops and all that kind of stuff, but threw for 140 yards. Including the 41-yarder to Colston Loveland that really put them in prime position to truly win that game. Absolutely phenomenal as far as that goes. And then when you look on the other side, you've got you've got Washington who passed for 255 yards. It's kind of what you would expect. Michael Penix was 27 for 51 with two interceptions and one touchdown. I mean, they only scored one touchdown all game. That's the ball game right there. So, pretty incredible stuff there. And rushing is even kind of more amazing because they held them to 46 yards rushing. We knew who they were, and they were not about that smoke. And it's in terms of Michigan didn't get a lot of in the sacks department. They got one thanks to Kenneth Grant blowing up that drive deep in Washington territory. So that was helpful. JJ McCarthy got sacked once as well. But obviously the big plays. Now, I just really think it's amazing, Mikey Sainer still, that he didn't end up having the turnover force in the Rose Bowl, but he did get it today. You just kind of know you won't, this was his last game, but you kind of just know he was good for it. And he came up with it in a time where Michigan really needed it. You could feel, even though this crowd, and I don't know if you could tell on TV or not, this crowd was probably 70-30 Michigan in terms of like disbursement. There was majority Michigan there. But you could sense the same type of change in crowd atmosphere and just excitement in the same way it was in the Rose Bowl, which was much more of a 60-40 Michigan advantage, where Alabama fans started getting really kind of hyped and rowdy. And Michigan fans started kind of sitting on their hands. They played Mr. Brightside, and it did not have the same resonance because it just felt, even though Alabama, not Alabama, but Washington was down, it really felt like, okay, they have the momentum. It's just a matter of time before they go down and do something. So Mikey Sainer was still getting that interception at that time on that place in the field. It is just the absolute clutch. The fact that he is able to do things like that. Absolutely, unbelievably phenomenal. what he has been able to do to this team from a leadership standpoint, from a playmaking standpoint. I mean, you would imagine he's got to go a lot higher in the draft than what many people might think, just because he has those attributes. He's a playmaker. When you think about when he took that Washington receiver and slung him down, right? It's a guy twice his size and he slings him down. He leads by example. And it was a lot of those types of guys. It was a good infusion of the elder statesmen, right? You had Donovan Edwards, who he and I have talked a lot about trusting in God and remaining patient and playing outside, not playing inside yourself, but playing outside yourself, right? Of just trusting in him. And he had come to me before the game, and that, I told him that, right? I'm like, just, you know, trust in the Lord. And he felt that today. So you have the guys like him. You have guys like Blake Corum, who would not be denied, right? Even though he had the long run, doesn't quite get into the end zone, ends up being a field goal. Then he tacks on two touchdowns, and in those touchdowns would not be denied. Absolutely phenomenal effort by those guys. The defense, just absolutely insane. One of the things is, so Mike McDonald was there at the game, and he's very humble about it. But I told him, I said, you started this, man. You started this. And he's like, no, I can't take credit for that. But we all know. Like, he started it. Jesse Minter finished it. So, exciting, exciting, exciting. All right, I promise there is still a really cool note that I want to share with you. We're going to get to that here in just one moment. But before we get to that, listen, I know you're excited about the national championship game, but that's just the appetizer, right? Because the entree is the NFL, or that's at least what all of the NFL fans want you to believe. but nonetheless, I mean, that's what a lot of people think, and it's ridiculous and absurd. But, you know, we still can have fun with the NFL by going to FanDuel, making it at least somewhat of an entertaining product, unlike what it normally is. Anyway, the NFL regular season has wrapped up, and there's still time to get in on the action out to the playoffs start next week on FanDuel. It's America's number one sports book. Right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets guaranteed when you place just a $5 bet. That's right. If you are terrible at picking, going and doing the money lines and all of that, you're just, you know, you couldn't hit the broadside of a barn with a dart or whatever. Guess what? You can make your $5 bet, get 150 bonus bucks back, regardless of win or lose. That's how great it is. The app is super easy to use. There's so many different ways you can bet with live same game parlays. You can find bets in the new Explore tab, make a parlay in the Parlay Hub. The best way to find popular parlays, and a heck of a lot more. So visit FanDuel.com/LockedOn. Make your first bet a layup. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL. All right, so let's finish up here. Keep this a little bit short and sweet here because it is back home 3:33 in the morning, 2:33 here local time. We do have a press conference in the morning, so I am excited to see what that's all about. But your national champion, Michigan Wolverines, before they became national champions. So this comes courtesy of a former player who won a national championship in 1997. Again, I don't know if they wanted me to name names, but I'm going to tell you the story they told me. So they went to there's a lot of those guys that were in town. I don't know all of who, right? But that there's a lot of them. And they all gathered together before the team departed for the stadium, which they did quite early. I think 3:45-ish, and they went and they lined at the team hotel, the escalator, the path from the escalator that the team would come down to the bus, and they greeted them all in this nice line, right? So as they were preparing to go to the stadium, as they had to walk through, they had to walk through essentially a Hall of Champions, the last team to do it for the Michigan Wolverines. How cool is that? How much does that just set the perfect stage for what happened today? And I mean, honestly, great thing that Michigan won with all of this stuff, but considering that, I mean, you would never, that's not the type of thing that you'd live down otherwise. But I mean, it was just a glorious day when it came to things like that, right? The fact that they won for Michi today, a year past his passing. The fact that they won a national championship 100 years ago. The fact that I didn't jinx it like some people thought. I didn't. All I did when I, if you don't know what I'm talking about, I tweeted the word soon. That's all I did. I tweeted the word soon with a question mark and a picture of the national championship trophy because it was sitting right over. They brought it out to show that it was coming, and people just, you're jinxing us. Listen, have ye little faith in the football team that you watched go 15-0 that you think that a person asking if they were going to win the championship soon is going to jinx them? Ha ha. Well, after that, Mikey Sainer still scored his little, or didn't score, but he got his little interception that he returned almost all the way. So take that and put that in your something. Okay. Anyway, so it still does not feel like a real scenario to me, but it will certainly, if I don't know about you, it will certainly continue to feel real over the course of this offseason, because Michigan's going to get to do stuff like have a parade. Michigan's going to get to do stuff like go to the White House. It is wild that Michigan just won a national championship. I just remember, and I'll close with this. After the 2021 loss to Georgia, sitting on the bus outside the Orange Bowl to go back to the media hotel, and I was sitting next to a colleague, and it was a colleague that wears their Michigan fandom on their sleeve. That they're great at what they do, but they're still very much a Michigan fan, and they let you know it. And they said to me, I just don't think that Michigan's ever going to do it, right? Like what we just saw there, that's what it takes. Michigan's never going to be there. And it was like a dawn realization. Hey, there are certain things Michigan can't do. And yet, here we are. Michigan did it. But one of the things that happened today that I did is I went to that NIL event that Michigan held for their donors. Great pitch from everyone. I'm not supposed to report on it, so I'm not going to report on it here. Absolutely wonderful pitch. But with that in mind, if you liked coming to the Rose Bowl, if you liked coming and seeing the Michigan win the national championship, if you liked sitting at home and watching it on TV or going to your favorite sports bar, whatever that is, you can help. You can help donate. Whether it's a little or a lot, there are people that were donating 5-6 figures today. They raised a lot of money. NIL is certainly back on track, it feels, based off of this. But you can help. If you want to keep coming to stuff like this, you can help be a part of the solution. And I understand there's mega donors that can help out a heck of a lot more, but you can be part of the solution. So that's my PSA, courtesy of Champions Circle. Anyway, that's going to do it for us. We will be back, I guess probably on Wednesday, maybe later Tuesday. I don't know. I'm just going to be writing and everything all day, probably, he says, before he doesn't do that. Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Happy National Championship. We will talk to you again soon. Peace.